Hello students, in the welcome in the next lecture of matrix algebra. Okay, so in the previous lecture we are going to study the matrix multiplication. Okay, in that we see the column definition of matrix multiplication and we solve examples on matrix multiplication. That is, we find the product of two matrices of order m cross n and n cross p. Okay, and by using the column definition of a matrix. Okay, and also we see the some properties of matrix multiplication. Okay, and then in today's lecture we are going to study the transpose of a matrix, and also we see the properties of transpose of a matrix. Then next to see inverse of a matrix, and also we see the properties of inverse of a matrix. Okay, so first we are going to study transpose of a matrix. Okay, in 12th science we see the concept, that is transpose of a matrix. We know that the definition of transpose of a matrix, but here again we see revise this concept, that is transpose of a matrix. So transpose of a matrix capital A, suppose we consider here matrix capital A, of a matrix capital A is denoted by notation A raised to capital T, that is A transpose, and is defined as columns of A transpose are formed by corresponding rows of capital A. Okay, that is, here if we have to given the matrix capital A, and from that if we have to find the transpose, that is the A transpose of this matrix A, then we have to only change that the rows will be considered as a column and column will be considered as a rows, then the new matrix will be the transpose of the given matrix capital A. Okay, then we see the properties of transpose of a matrix. For that we see the theorem. Statement of the theorem is, let capital A and B be matrices such that the product and addition of A and B is defined. Then first one is A plus B transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. Then second one is A transpose is equal to A itself. Okay, then third one is A into B transpose is equal to A into B transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Fourth one is, for any scalar small r belongs to capital R, R into A transpose is equal to R into A transpose. Okay, these are the properties of transpose of the given matrix. Okay, here we consider A and B be the matrices, that is two matrices, such that their product and addition must be defined. We know that when the product and addition is defined, when the two matrices A and B are of the same size, and product will be defined of when The number of columns of A must be equal to the number of rows of B. Okay. Then first one is A plus B transpose will be equivalent to A transpose plus B transpose. Second one is A transpose transpose. That is, if we take the transpose of transpose, then we get itself matrix A. Then for third one is the A into B transpose will be equivalent to, that is, product of AB transpose will be equivalent to the product of B transpose into A transpose. And last one is the, for any scalar R belongs to real numbers capital R, if we consider R into A transpose, which is equivalent to R into A transpose. That is, here either we first multiply this R scalar into A and then we take transpose, which is equivalent to, if we take first A transpose and then we multiply that A transpose matrix, that is, we multiply this scalar R into A transpose, then we have to get the same answer. Okay. So these are the properties of matrices. Here this third number, third property, that is, here we consider only for two matrices, then this property is generalized. Also this property is generalized for more than two matrices also. Okay. So then next we see example on it, transpose of a matrix. Okay. So here we write the example. Let U is equal to this matrix, that is the column matrix, and we consider column matrix which is of order 3 cross 1, so it is the vector in R raised to 3. Okay. Again, V is the column matrix of order 3 cross 1, so it is the vector in R raised to 3. So here we have to given that U and V belongs to the vectors in R raised to 3, R3. And from that we have to find U transpose into V and V transpose into U. Okay. So first here U will be given that, we write here matrix minus 2, 3 and minus 4. Then from that we can write it transpose, that is, we have to only change the columns of this matrix as a rows for U transpose. So we write it as, we get U transpose is equal to minus 2, 3 and minus 4. Row becomes column and column becomes rows. Okay. So we have to get this. Then by using column definition, we can write U transpose is in column definition form. That is, we consider first column as U1, second column as U2 and third column will be U3. Okay. Then first we have to find U transpose into V. Okay. So first we find U transpose into V. Here we write first U transpose matrix in column definition form, that is U1, U2, U3, these three columns, and V be the matrix we have to given that, that is column matrix of order 3 cross 1. So we write here value U1, U2, U3 will be as it is, and V column matrix which contains these entries A, B, C. Okay. Then by using column definition we can find the product. Okay, we see that in previous lecture. So we have to get this product will be A into U1 plus B into U2 plus C into U3. Okay, so we put here value. Here we write U transpose is in column form. So from that we get here, we write here U1 will be equal to minus 2, this column, then U2 will be equal to 3 and U3 will be equal to minus 4, which are the columns. Okay, we put here these values, we get U transpose into V is equal to U1, value of U1 will be minus 2 into A. U1 and A both are the scalars, so we write in this order also. Then plus B, value of U2 will be 3, that is plus 3B, and C will be minus 4, sorry, and U3 will be minus 4, so we write here minus 4 into C. So we get U transpose into V is equal to this. Then similarly we find next, that is V transpose into U. Okay. So we have to given that V be the column matrix which contains these ABC entries from the real numbers that is of order 3 cross. So V transpose is equal to, we get, we have to interchange rows and columns, we get this will be ABC, that is the row matrix. Okay. Then V transpose we can write in column definition form. So we consider these columns are first V1, second V2 and third V3. Okay. Then we find V transpose into U. Here V1 will be equal to where V1 will be A, then V2 will be B and V3 will be C. Okay. Then we find V transpose into U. V transpose, we write the matrix in column form V1, V2, V3. Okay. And U will be the matrix. We have to given that. We write U as it is first. Then we put the values V1, V2, V3. And U be the column matrix, that is minus 2, 3, minus 4. Okay. Then V transpose into U is equal to minus 2 V1 plus 3 V2 minus 4 V3. Okay, then we put your values of V1, V2, V3. Minus 2 V1 will be A plus 3 B minus 4 C. Okay, minus 2 A plus 3 B minus 4 C. Okay, this is the V transpose into U. So here we have to get V transpose into U and U transpose into V will be same. So in this way we find the this product. Okay, here we write the next example. We have to given that A be the matrix will be this 1 minus 3 minus 2 4 is of order 2 cross 2. Okay, then X be the column matrix of order 2 cross 1, that is which is the vector belongs to R2. Okay, then from that we have to find AX, first A into X transpose, then X transpose into A transpose, then X into X transpose, and also we have to ask either A transpose into X transpose is defined or not. So from that first we find this. Okay, so first we find A into X transpose. Okay, A into X transpose, first we find the product A into X and then we take the transpose of that product matrix to get AX transpose. Okay, so we find this product A into X by using to find first by using column definition. So first we find A into X. Okay, for that A be the matrix we can write is in column form, that is here matrix A is of order 2 cross 2, that is 2 columns 2 rows. So we consider these columns as A1 and A2, where we write here column A1 will be we consider, that is 1 minus 2 first column, and second column A2 will be minus 3 4. Okay, this will be 4. Okay, then we find A into X. So first we write matrix A is in column definition form A1 A2 and X be the this column vector 5 3. We write as it is. Okay, then we know that how to take this multiplication. So we get here 5 A1 plus 3 A2. Then we put here values of columns A1 and A2. A into X into X will be equal to 5. Value of A1 will be 1 minus 2 plus 3. Value of A2 will be column minus 3, 4. Okay, then we take this scalar multiplication. 5 into 1 will be 5. 5 into minus 2 will be minus 10 plus 3 into minus 3 minus 9. 3 into 4 will be 12. Then by taking addition of these two column matrices we get 5 minus 9 will be minus 4, minus 10 plus 12 will be plus 2. So we get this is the product A into X. Then we have to find AX transpose. So we take its transpose. then we get ax transpose will be equal to minus 4, 2. That is, we have to consider these rows as a columns and this column as a row. That is, if we take transpose of column matrix, then we have to get the row matrix. Okay, so this is the value of ax transpose. Then next we have to find the x transpose into a transpose. Here we use the properties of transpose. We know that a into b transpose is equal to b transpose into a transpose. So by using this, we have to get A into X transpose is equal to X transpose into A transpose. Here we find the value of AX transpose will be this. That is, we write here minus 4 to this matrix, row matrix. So X transpose into A transpose will be same as A into X transpose. So we get X transpose into A transpose is equal to this row matrix, which contains minus 4, minus 4, 2. Okay. Then next, to find x into x transpose. Okay. So we find here x in third one. We have to find x into x transpose. Okay. So here we write the value of x. X will be 5, 3, column matrix. Then its transpose, that is, we have to write this matrix in row. We have to get this transpose, that is the row matrix 5, 3. Then by taking this multiplication, that is product of this matrix, here x is of order 2 cross 1, and here matrix x transpose is of order 1 cross 2. So number of rows is equal to number of columns in X is equal to the number of rows in X transpose. Therefore, matrix multiplication is defined, and we get this multiplication. We have to get this multiplication will be equal to 5 into 5 will be 25. In this rule, we can find multiplication also. 5 into 5 will be 25. 5 into 3 will be 15. 5 into 3 will be 15, and 3 into 3 will be 9. So we get it is the matrix of order 2 cross 2. Number of rows in X must, and number of columns in X transpose, that is the order of X into X transpose. Okay, then here we have to also ask the question whether, that is fourth number is whether A transpose into X transpose is defined or not. We have to find either this defined or not. A is the matrix of order 2 cross 2. Okay. And here we find X transpose. X transpose is of order. X transpose is of order 1 cross 2. Okay. We know that whether the product of two matrices is defined when number of columns of A must be equal to the number of rows of B. Okay, here A matrix, that is A, and B matrix will be X transpose. Here number of columns of A, number of columns of A will be here 2, and number of columns of A will be equal to 2, and here number of rows of X transpose will be equal to 1. 2 is not equal to 1. Therefore, A transpose into X transpose is not defined. Okay. So, here this product is not defined. So, here we see the next inverse of a matrix. We know that what is the inverse. If X belongs to R and X is not equal to 0, then 1 by X, or we can write it as X inverse, is a inverse of X is the inverse of x. If it satisfies the equation, if it satisfies the equation x into x inverse, x into x inverse is equal to 1. Okay, then we say that this 1 by x is the inverse of the real number x. Okay, so here we have to see the inverse of the matrix, or when the given matrix is the invertible matrix. So we first write the definition and n cross n matrix capital A is said to be invertible if there exist n cross n matrix C such that A into C is equal to I and C into A also equal to I n, where I n is a identity matrix of order n cross n. Then C is called inverse of A, that is inverse of matrix capital A. Okay, and the inverse matrix is uniquely defined. That is, if the given matrix is invertible, that is, it has inverse matrix exists, then which is always the unique, that is, inverse of given matrix is always a unique, inverse will be uniquely exist. Okay, then we write, so a matrix which is not invertible is called a singular matrix, and a matrix which is invertible is called non-singular matrix. Okay. Okay, see the theorem on properties of invertible matrix. Theorem: let capital A and B be invertible matrices. Capital A and B be the invertible matrices. Then first A inverse is equal to A, itself equal to A. Here if A is invertible matrix, then it exists. Then second one is, if A into B, this product is invertible, then we write here A into B inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Okay, then third one is, if A transpose is invertible, then A transpose inverse must be is equal to A inverse transpose. So these are the properties of invertible matrices. That is, if given matrices A and B are invertible, then if we take inverse of inverse, that is we take inverse of the given matrix two times, then which is must be equal to itself matrix A. Here necessary is that the A inverse will be exist. Okay, then second is, if product of AB matrix has inverse exists, that is A into B is invertible, then A into B inverse must be equivalent to B inverse into A inverse. And third one is, A transpose is invertible. If the transpose of matrix is invertible, then we can write A transpose inverse must be equal to A inverse transpose. Okay, then next we see the next theorem, that the inverse of 2 by 2 matrix. That is, theorem is, if capital A is the matrix, we consider which entries are A, B, C, D of order 2 cross 2, then A inverse is equal to 1 upon AD minus BC into the matrix which entries are D minus B minus C A. Okay, if here condition is that AD minus BC is not equal to 0. Okay, that is the formula for finding the inverse of 2 by 2 matrix, where here condition is that AD minus BC is not equal to 0. We know that what is value of AD minus BC, that is the determinant of a 2 by 2 matrix. That is, if given 2 by 2 matrix has determinant is not equal to 0, then that matrix is invertible, and A inverse will be defined as 1 upon determinant of A, that is AD minus BC into here this matrix. That is, we have to interchange these two elements D and A, and we have to take these two elements as the negative sign. So we get, this is the formula. So by using this formula, we can find the inverse of 2 by 2 matrix. So we see one example, and also here note that if AD minus BC is equal to 0, and if AD minus BC is equal to 0, then A inverse is not exist, that is A is not invertible. So we write here, that is A is not, then A is not invertible. So using this formula, we can solve the example. Let capital A is equal to the matrix which contains entries 3, 2, 7, 4. Then find A inverse. Here we see the simple example. Okay. So first, here is the matrix of order 2 cross 2. So first we find the determinant of this matrix. That is, if we compare this matrix with this matrix A, B, C, D, then compare with, or not necessary to write this all. Okay, so here AB is in this form, so we get AD minus BC is equal to, here A will be 3, B will be 4, so we get here 3 into 4 minus 7 into 2, that is determinant. 3 into 4 will be 12, minus 7 into 2 will be minus 14. So 12 minus 14, we get minus 2, which is not equal to 0. We get AD minus BC is not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists, and by using this formula, we get A inverse is equal to 1 upon AD minus BC into minus B minus C A. Okay, so we put here values, 1 upon AD minus BC we have to get minus 2, and here we have to interchange these two, so we get here 4. here will be 3 and we change or we take here the negative sign for these elements entries, so we get minus 2 minus 7. So this is the inverse of the given matrix, 2 by 2 matrix. In this way we can easily find by using this formula inverse of the matrix. Important theorem, so we write that theorem. First theorem is that if capital A is an invertible n cross n matrix and B belongs to R raised to n, B any vector, then the matrix equation A into X is equal to B has a unique solution X is equal to A inverse into B. We have to prove this theorem, that is we have to see the proof of this theorem. Okay, so we have to given that here, well, A is invertible, A is an invertible matrix of order n cross n. If A is an invertible matrix, then by using definition of invertible matrix, here A inverse must be exist. Okay, then next we have to given that B belongs to R raised to n, that is B is the column matrix of order n cross 1. Then the matrix equation Ax is equal to B has a unique solution. We have to prove that this. The matrix equation Ax is equal to B has a unique solution, that is value of this X will satisfy this equation and which is the unique value, that is we have to show that. Okay, we know that how to show the solution of the given equation. If we put that value in that equation and if the value satisfies the equation, that is we have to get LHS is equal to RHS, then we say that value is the solution of the given equation. Okay, so we use that method here. Matrix equation is Ax is equal to B and we have to given that value of X will be X is equal to A inverse into B. So we consider LHS of equation 1, say it as equation 1, LHS will be A into X and we put here value of X will be A inverse into B here. So A will be as it is, value of X will be A inverse into B. Write in bracket X is equal to A inverse into B. Okay, then here A with the matrix of order n cross n, A inverse is also the matrix of order n cross n and B is the vector, that is column matrix of order n cross 1. So these three are the matrices and we know that the matrices satisfies the associative law. So we can write this multiplication as A into A inverse in one bracket into B by associative law. Okay, then here A be the invertible matrix, that is A inverse is exist, then by definition of A inverse, that is invertible matrix, A into A inverse must be, we get IN into B. A is a invertible, so we can write A into A inverse is equal to identity matrix, that is that matrix into this inverse must be, we have to get the identity matrix by using definition. So we get A into X is equal to, and here IN, that is identity matrix of order n cross n, and B is the column matrix of order n cross 1. So we know that identity matrix into any matrix we have to get that itself matrix. So we have to get IN into B will be B. So we get here AX is equal to B, that is equal to the RHS of equation 1. This implies that X is equal to A inverse into B is a solution of AX is equal to B. Okay, then next we have to prove that the solution has a unique solution, that is we have to prove the uniqueness. Then to prove uniqueness, okay, for proving uniqueness here we consider U B any other solution let here we can U be the any other solution of equation AX is equal to B. Here we consider U be the any another solution of equation AX is equal to B, and if U be the solution of this equation, so U satisfies this equation. This implies that U satisfies AX is equal to B, and if U satisfies this equation, so we get A into U is equal to B. Okay, so and here we have to given that A be the invertible matrix, so A inverse is exist, so we multiply both sides by A inverse. Okay, then we get A inverse A into U is equal to A inverse into B. In bracket we write A inverse is exist. We have to given that. Then again by using associative law we can write it as A inverse into A U is equal to A inverse into B. Then A inverse into A we have to get the identity matrix, that is IN into U is equal to A inverse into B. Again IN be the identity matrix, so we get IN into U will be U is equal to U, and here A inverse into B. So we have to get the value of U, that is another solution is also A inverse into B. So from that we get U is equal to X, because X is also the A inverse into B. So we can say that the given equation X is equal to B has a unique solution, that is A inverse into B. In this way we can prove the uniqueness of the solution. Okay. So in today's lecture we stop here. Thank you.